Hello students, today we are going to discuss next important topic which has been prescribed into your syllabus by Punjab University Chandigarh. So the topic which we are going to discuss today is types of communication process. I repeat, the topic which we are going to discuss today is types of communication process. So let us begin with our today's topic. Communication can be categorized into different types depending upon the level at which it takes place, the direction it takes, or by its very nature. Some of the common referred types of communication are, so first, communication can be categorized into different types depending upon the level at which it takes place. So there are different types of communication, and the types of communication depend upon the level at which it takes place, the direction it takes, or by its very nature. So there are different types of communication. Some of the common referred types of communication are, the very first type is personal communication and business communication. This is very first type, personal communication and business communication. Personal communication, it concerns communication that takes place between any two individuals, be it in a family, group, community, or even an organization. So a communication that takes place between any two individuals in family, group, community, or even an organization, that is called personal communication. It can take the form of personal letters, personal telephone calls, conversations, one-to-one meetings, or email messages. So it can take place in all these forms, in any of these forms, like personal letters, telephonic calls, conversation, one-to-one meetings, or email messages. It is private in nature and there is nothing official about it. Private and confidential conversation between two individuals is also referred to as tete-a-tete. So it is a private conversation or communication. Next is business communication. Business communication, it takes place to further the goals of a business. It takes place among business entities in markets and marketplaces, within organizations, and between various groups of employers, owners and employees, buyers and sellers, service providers and customers, salesperson and prospects, and also between people within the organization and press persons. So business communication takes place to further or to decide what to do in future about the goals of business. It takes place among business entities, markets and marketplaces, or various groups of employers and employees, owners, buyers and sellers, service providers and customers, salespersons and prospects. Means it takes place in different types of business related people. Business communication is nothing but the communication between the people in the organization for the purpose of carrying out the business activities. It may be oral, verbal, written, etc. So business communication can take place in any type, in any form, like oral, verbal, or written, etc. Business communication is any communication used to build partnerships, intellectual resources to promote an idea, a product, service, or any organization with the objective of creating value to your business. So, business communication takes place to build partnership with any organization, intellectual resources to promote an idea or any product or any service or any organization. So these are personal and business communications. Next is internal and external communication. Internal communication. It takes place within the organization or group, among people, within, among different groups of employees, and between employers and employees. Internal communication takes place within the organization or group, among people within, among different groups of employees, and between employers and employees. It could be oral or written, visual or audiovisual, formal or informal, upward or downward. Internal communication serves to inform, instruct, educate, develop, motivate, persuade, entertain, direct, control, and caution people in the organization. So, what is the purpose of internal communication? It serves to inform, instruct, educate, motivate, persuade, develop, entertain, direct, control, and caution the people or employees in any organization. So this is internal communication. Next is external communication. Unlike internal communication, external communication flows outward. It addresses people outside the organization, like the prospective customers, competitors, public, press, media, and the government. So it is an outward communication. External communication can take place in various ways and through different channels. Letters, notices, brochures, demonstrations, telephone calls, business meetings, press releases, press conferences, audio-visual presentations, publicity films, product launch events, and advertisements are all examples of external communication. So all these are, all this comes under the external or outward communication. Next is upward and downward communication. Downward communication. It is eminently suited to an organization in which the line of authority runs distinctly downwards, with each rank clearly below another. Downward communication. It is suited to an organization or any company in which the line of authority runs distinctly downwards, with each rank clearly below another, to which it is directly related. Downward communication flows from a superior to the subordinate staff. I repeat the sentence. Downward communication flows from a superior to the subordinate staff means which is under any higher authority. The objectives of downward communication are to give directives about some job, to explain policies and procedures, to convey assessment of performance, to explain the rationale of the job. So these are the objectives of a downward communication. Next, there are the limitations of downward communication. The very first limitation is under communication or over communication. Next is, in case the communication becomes very long, it may lead to unnecessary delay. In case the communication becomes very long or lengthy, it may lead to unnecessary delay. Next is, it provides feedback. This is the limitation. It provides feedback. There are some demerits of downward communication. First demerit is distortion of information. Next is, distortion means to spoil something. Next word is, may transmit incomplete information. It's the possibility that downward communication may transmit, may convey incomplete information. Next is, it travels with destructive swiftness. Swift means with fast pace or with speed. Downward communication travels with destructive swiftness. Next is to use effectively, the manager should. To use the downward communication effectively, the manager of any organization or any company should do all these things which are written below. Very first is, keep an eye on the rumor mongers. Next is, use it primarily for feedback. Next is, contradict rumors promptly. Next is, involve the workers in the decision-making process. So all these things a manager should keep in his mind while using the downward communication. So students, today we have discussed some types of communication like personal and business communication, internal and external communication, upward and downward communication, and its the objectives, limitations, demerits of downward communication, and try to learn all these types of communication. Tomorrow we will continue with our next lecture. Thank you very much.